Hi mommies and daddies, welcome back to Momcom India. If you're watching me for the first time, my name is Mansi and I have an adorable 18-month-old boy whose name is Kabir. So in this video, I'm going to share with you his latest daily routine. अगर आप एक हिंदी व्यूअर हो तो इस टॉपिक का जो हिंदी वर्जन है वो कल हमने अपने चैनल पे पोस्ट किया था, आप वो जाके देख सकते हो. सो गाइज, बिफोर आई स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो, वन रिक्वेस्ट, प्लीज़ फॉलो अस ऑन फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम बाय सर्चिंग मॉमकॉम इंडिया एंड लाइकिंग एंड फॉलोइंग आवर पेज. अदरवाइज यू आर मिसिंग सो मेनी नाइस अपडेट्स ऑफ आवर बेबी ग्रोइंग अप. Also, definitely like this video if you find this to be helpful and subscribe to our channel by hitting on the red button below and clicking on the bell icon. Let's get started. So if you've been following my channel for quite some time, I had already posted a video on baby routine. At that time, my baby was about 12 months of age and he's gone through a complete change when it comes to a daily routine. He's gone down from 2 naps in a day to 1 nap in a day, which is a big change for him, because 1 nap in a day means that the rest of the day there are a lot of activities, there are a lot of things happening, and what is that is exactly what you'll get to know in this video. So let me tell you that the last video that I did on baby routine, my baby was around 12 months of age at that time, and the big change that has happened to him from then to his routine right now is that his sleep pattern has changed. His number of naps in the day has come from 2 naps to 1 nap. So earlier my baby used to take 2 naps, one at around 10 in the morning and second in the afternoon. Now he only takes 1 nap, which is the afternoon nap. Now with the sleep change, obviously the entire day's routine is going to change, and that's exactly what has happened in our case. Let me tell you the entire day routine first and then talk about some of the changes and how they happen. So now our day starts anywhere between 8 to 9 in the morning. Let's consider for this video that my baby gets up at 8:30 in the morning, which is the first big change. He earlier used to get up at 6 in the morning. So he gets up at 8:30 in the morning, and the first thing that I do even before getting him out from bed is offering him milk. At that time, I give him milk through bottle, and that is cow milk with some added sugar. So now this does 2 things. One is that by taking milk immediately, he's more comfortable in the bed. He will take milk easily without any distraction. That fills his stomach. Plus sugar gives him that instant boost of energy that he requires. Now a lot of you will be thinking that why is that something that I'm doing? If you followed my last video, you know, I had talked about how he gets up at 6 in the morning, then I offer him a few sips of lukewarm water, then he clears his stomach and we start the entire activity, we go out and you know, we go to the park and all of that happens. So I made this change because of a couple of reasons. I saw that as he's got more confident about walking and being independent, he likes to get into action the moment he's up. He wants to go out, he wants to play with his toys, he wants to play with the ball, with the bat and all of that. And because I was not giving him milk immediately, I was giving him water, we were going through the activities of clearing the stomach, brushing and all of that, then going out, then it took me some time to make cornflakes for him or oats or whatever I was offering at that time for him. You know, my baby would be very lazy at that time. He would feel very lethargic. He would not be very happy in spite of having a very good night's sleep. And at times he would not even give me time to make food for him. He would have that urge that, you know, I should just be with him. He would start becoming a little cranky. So I saw that, you know, why is it that he doesn't have energy in the morning? What is the change? He wants to play, but somehow he doesn't have the energy or that mood to play only. So we immediately decided to make this switch. We immediately decided to give him something that will give him a rush in his body and a boost of energy in his body, and will fill his stomach for at least an hour, hour and a half, so that I can make good breakfast for him. Because he started sleeping in the night, so his stomach is empty by the time he gets up in the morning. So we made this change, and this change has done wonders to our life. I am seeing a completely happy baby who's most happy in the morning, especially in the first 1.5 hours. He has that energy, he just goes out and, you know, starts playing. So what we do is we give him milk at 8:30 in the morning. After that, within 10 to 15 minutes, because it's hot milk, that immediately stimulates the pressure and he poops. And also what I try to do is that within the room, I try to play some games with him where he'll sit and stand. So that way there's more pressure and he will feel the need to poop. So he poops, and then, you know, I will clean him off completely. I'll clean his diaper area because he's been in the diaper throughout the night. We would do brush together. So he and I like to do the brush. We like to brush our teeth together. It's a fun activity for us. and then I will change him, and then he's ready for outside. So within like 15 to 20 minutes, we are ready for outside. We go in our living room, and that's where all his toys are, and he starts playing. This is the second change. Earlier, after going out, after spending 10-15 minutes and having his conflicts, we used to go to the park. But now, because right now it's monsoon, you know, it's not very cool, it's humid, you can't take him to the park at this hour. So that the park time in the morning is a sacrifice in his this routine. But I'm happy with the sacrifice, and I'll tell you why towards the end of the video. Then we go out, then between like a 9 to 9:15, which is 30 to 45 minutes after giving him cow milk, I will offer him, you know, a fruit, which will typically be an apple or a banana. And I'll do that because I still have to make breakfast for him, and that's the time I'm engaged with him. So while playing, you know, I will offer him banana and apple, and he'll eat easily. And at that time, we'll read a book, or we'll do some music or some activity. And then after that, you know, he plays with his grandparents, and which is when I make the breakfast for him. So by 10 o'clock, I will give him breakfast. Anywhere between 9:45 to 10 o'clock, I'll give him breakfast. And breakfast will be a variety. You know, it could be egg, it could be French toast, it could be pancake, it could be paratha. So basically different things that I'll try to do a complete diet chart video on this for this age. So that's something that I give him at that time. After that, his energy gets transformed to his dad, who wakes up at 10 in the morning because he comes a little late in the night from work. So at 10 o'clock, he will go, after finishing his breakfast, wake up his daddy, and will spend a good time with his dad, and we all will also play. So there's a lot of play time that happens between a 10 to a 11:30. Then at 11:30, I will offer him some drink. Now, drink for me are just two options at this point of time. One can be a fresh juice. Typically, it's like a Malta or a Mosmi juice, or it'll be coconut water. So that hydrates him quite a lot. We keep giving him water throughout the day. But apart from this, I feel these fluids are also important, because in this weather, kids tend to sweat so much. So 11:30, he has his drink. Then by 12:15, he will go with his dad and go for his massage and bath routine. So 15 to 20 minutes of massage, followed by a lukewarm water bath, is what he'll take. And then he'll be absolutely ready at 1 o'clock. So at 1 to 1:15, he'll be offered lunch, which typically will be a rice based meal, and he takes about 20 minutes to 30 minutes to finish his food. So by 1:45, he'll be done with his lunch. Then I'll give him about 15 minutes to just chill and relax and, you know, digest the food that he's eaten. And between a 2 to 2:30, he will go down for his one and only nap in the day. But this will be a long nap. So between 2 to 2:30, he'll go down for his nap for about 2.5 to 3 hours. There are times when he would want some milk, you know, maybe like an ounce or 2 ounces. But there are times that he would want to skip milk completely at this time. So say he went down for his nap at 2:30, he'll get up anywhere between a 5 to 5:30. So 5 to 5:30, when he gets up, then 15 to 20 minutes it will take for him to be active. And since he slept for so long and he hasn't eaten anything, after say a 15-20 minutes, he'll start to get that hunger pang and he'll want to eat something. So 6 o'clock is when I take him to the park. So before that, I try to feed him something. It could be yogurt, flavored yogurt. He loves that. It could be cheese slices. It could be a fruit that he'd want to have. It could be a meetha pura if he's like really hungry and has like a sugar craving. So depending on what he's been eating for the last few days, you know, I'll give him something. And then 6 o'clock, we hit the park. So we go to the park, and we for about hour and a half, depending on his mood and his energy, we'll be in the park, and we'll do a lot of activities in the park. Lot of running, lot of football, lot of basketball, lot of playing with the other kids, swings, you know, there are a lot of things. Kabir does not like to do sit down activities. He's like on the run mostly. So he'll do a lot of activities, and a lot of his energy from what he's eaten will get consumed at this point of time. 7:30, he comes back, and since he's so dehydrated at that point of time, within 15 to 20 minutes after cleaning him up, washing his hands, feet, face, everything, we offer him a lemon drink. So that's like a nimbu pani, sweet salted lemon drink is what we give him, so that, you know, he gets his energy back and he feels very fresh. So that happens. Then again, there is indoor playtime. He has a lot of nice toys that he plays with. If you've not watched his toys video, I've done a lot of recommendations on what toys for what age. So you can see that. And anywhere between 8:30 to 8:45, he'll be offered dinner, which will be normally a chapati and a rice combo meal with chicken curry. Normally, he loves to have chicken. So he will be given chicken almost like on a daily basis, because I don't think it's like roti for him. He has to eat it daily. So he'll take that, and by 9:15, he'll be done with his food. And the next 45 minutes to 30 minutes, depending on his energy, will be a calm time, but a calm play time. So you still have to play with him because he still has energy and he's up, but it'll be calm play time. So things like drawing, things like coloring, artwork with pen, writing, cards, games, reading storybooks, is all the different things that we will do at this point of time. And then 10 o'clock, Kabir will again take a bottle of milk. He's just used to that. So he'll take a bottle of milk, which will again be cow milk. But this time I won't give him sugar, because over the period of night, it is suggested that you don't give sugar because it causes tooth decay. Because you're not brushing at that point of time. The child is so sleepy that he takes the bottle, has his milk and sleeps. So I don't put sugar at that time, and then he sleeps. And now Kabir has started to sleep overnight. There will be some nights, because of teething he'll get up, or because of thirst he'll get up, and there will be very few nights where he'll get up because of hunger, which is when we will give him formula milk, because I still don't know that how do you store cow milk in your room. I would love your suggestions on that in case you're already doing that. I still have to check on that. But because I don't know that, what I'm doing as a safe option is we keep boiled water in the Milton bottle and make formula just in case he needs milk at any point of time in the night. So that's pretty much, then he has a happy sleep throughout the night and he gets up as a happy baby. So that's the whole change of routine that I'm having with Kabir at this point of time. Obviously, there are weekends and there are daddy days, and then there are activities or events or gatherings where his routine will slightly change, especially his sleeping time will change in the night. But during the day, we try to stick to his schedule as much as we can. That's one thing that has remained constant with us right from the start. We focus too much about his comfort on sleeping, because we feel that sleeping can make a whole lot of difference about how we feel, and that applies to us also, right? So with babies, it's all the more important because they can't communicate as to how they are feeling or when they are tired and when not. So I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you did, please click on the like button. Please share, subscribe, and definitely comment and let me know below as to what's happening with your babies. How are you managing the routine or managing the change? I'd love to hear from you as well. Thank you so much for watching MomCom India. See you soon.